Today, I'll show you how to play Tetris online. I love Tetris. It's the only game I'm addicted to, and I can't wait to show you how to play it. Let's go. So, as you might know, the game of Tetris is basically pieces falling down, and you have to put them together so that you can get rid of lines as fast as possible. You know which pieces will come next in the box next, and the pieces that are falling down you can rotate with the up arrow, and you can put them left or right with the left or right arrow, and put them down with the arrow down. You can hold a piece also with the C, and you can like use it later by pressing C again later on. Here I can press C again, and here you go. I hold another piece and I use the piece that was on hold. That is especially useful if you want to hold a long bar, as you will see next. So the purpose of the game is to stack pieces as efficiently as possible without leaving holes, because holes will get your stack higher and higher, and if it goes to the very top, you lose. So this is an example of me stacking pieces. And I want to create what we call a well, which is the gap on the very right, to put a long bar and get rid of four lines at a time. So here I'm stacking pieces as fast as possible, because as you can see with the score, you can get more points by dropping them faster. Here I have a long bar. Finally, I can drop it in the well and get rid of four lines. This is called a Tetris. That's what a Tetris is. It gets rid of four lines at a time, and it's the maximum score you can get by getting rid of lines. When you get rid of one or two lines, for example, your score is less. As you can see here, you only have like 300 points for two lines, whereas you get more than like 1,000 for four lines at a time. As you can see on the left panel, you have the score, the level, and the number of lines. This is important. See, the more lines you get rid of, the higher the level. But levels are also important, because the higher the level, the faster the game goes. You'll see that when I'll cut to the end of the game, where at level 20, 25, it goes kind of fast, and you don't have time to think too much about where to place it, how to rotate it. When you're a beginner, you can soft drop using the bottom arrow, and you have time to rotate the pieces, see, before it locks in a specific position. You can also fast drop or hard drop using the space key, and see, it's much faster. It gets you more points, but that's as you get better and better at the game. So I can't really teach you or tell you how to drop pieces faster. It's through practice that you can be able to do this, by knowing in advance what kind of a stack position allows which piece to go where. And as you practice and improve, you're able to go at faster and faster speeds, and get more points basically. A strategy I like is to keep a long bar on hold and wait until it gets a bit more difficult to place the pieces, and or when it gets really high, and then to drop the long bar and get a Tetris. Also, I find it fun to stack up really high and get multiple Tetrises. It's more, yeah, it's more fun, more suspense. The rest of the game is pretty much the same. I use the same techniques. That's why I speed it up, because you just put your well either on the right or the left. Most people use it on the right, and you drop the long bars in it to get maximum points every time. And as you can see around level 15, 16, it gets really fast. And And yeah, you mess up at one point. Yeah, but you just have to try and keep the same tactic, and just get through it. This also is learned through practice. And so holes makes your stack go higher without the possibility to clear those lines. So it's you're trying to avoid them at all costs, or to prevent them until later on when it gets really fast, like right now. And towards the end, it gets way too fast to properly place them anyway. So you just try to do your best and get maybe one or two lines before the end when you just have to lose.
Yeah, that's about it. That's how you play Tetris on this website, tetris.com. Other versions may be harder because sometimes you can't rotate the pieces once it touches the stack, and that's harder to play. This is maybe the easiest website to play it on. This beginner's method allows you to get scores on up to 600, 700, maybe 800,000 points if you play it very well, if you practice often. After a couple of months, you can like play as fast as I can and get up until like 800,000 points. But not very higher, because at level 25, 26, it's way too fast to get rid of lines. So you need to develop better techniques that I might describe in another video. If you like, watch it. And until then, good luck with Tetris.